Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will let you know how to add appointments of multiple resources to the Blazor Scheduler. Before proceeding further, first let me clear the term resource refers here in this phrase multiple resources. The term resource in this scheduler context can be anything like a person, task, or any object that exhibits action over a time period. Look at the scheduler now, it displays various appointments in different colors. Each of these colors represents that this particular appointment belongs to a specific person. Here, I will proceed to show you how to define the resource data to the Blazor Scheduler through code example, and how to add the appointments of multiple resources on the same scheduler layout and differentiate them with different colors. Now, I am going to continue with the existing Blazor application, where I have added a Blazor Scheduler with few normal appointments. If you want to know how to add appointments to the Blazor Scheduler, you can look onto the Getting Started video, shown in the above YouTube card to know its basic steps. Also, I will share with you the reference link of that video in the description part below. Here, I am going to run this application to show you the output of this example. So here, you can view the scheduler with few normal appointments. Now, I will show you how to define the resource data to the Blazor Scheduler. As a first step, within the schedule code, I need to define the schedule resources tag, which accepts any number of schedule resource tags inside it. Here, I have planned to add single level resource. So, let me define a single schedule resource tag. Next, I will proceed to show you how to define resource data to the Blazor Scheduler. For that, first I need to create a model class named resource data model with three fields: person ID, person name, and color. Then, I need to create a list of resource data of the type resource data model and assigned an array of objects to it. Now, I will define tItem and tValue properties with the appropriate values to specify the resource data source type and field type of the resource ID. And then, I will assign this object resource data to the data source property of resource collection. Next, I also need to add resource ID to the scheduled appointment. So, within this appointment data model class, let me define one more property resource ID of type integer and set applicable values to it. Here, this schedule resource supports a huge number of sub-options within it. So, let me show you those options one by one. The first option is field. So, I will define the property field and assign its value as resource ID. This value indicates that the resource ID field to be mapped from the event object. You can see here, I have provided the resource ID value as 1, which means this appointment belongs to the resource whose ID value is 1. That is, this particular appointment belongs to the resource John, as its ID matches with the value 1. Similarly, the other two appointments were also mapped with their respective resources. The next option is title. So, I will define the property title with the value resources to set a label for the resource field on the editor window. And the next option is the name property, and I will set the value as resource name for it. This option will be utilized while working with the grouping concept. As I'm not going to include the grouping option here, therefore, I have no work with this name option in this example, but I will tell you how it works. Whatever name that you assign for the resources should be unique always, to identify that resource from the huge collection of resources. So, using this unique name, I can group them on the scheduler layout. I will show you this step in my next video of the grouping concept. So now, let me continue with the other options of resources. Next comes the three important fields: text field, ID field, and color field. These are the mapper fields of resource data source. Therefore, to specify the resource collection, let me define all the three fields here and map appropriate resource data source fields to them. Okay, now all is set. So let's look at the scheduler output now, where you can find the appointments of the resources with different colors, and when you double-click on this appointment, you can see the editor window gets opened. Here, you can see the resource name is John, which implies that the appointment belongs to John. Also, I have set the title for the resource as resources, which gets reflected in the editor window like this. See the resources field, you can select only one resource at a particular time. In case if I want to select multiple resources for the same appointment, then Within the Schedule Resource tag, let me define the property AllowMultiple and set its value as true. Then, I also need to change the tValue property as an integer array, as it needs to accept multiple resource IDs. Look at the scheduler now. When you double-click on the appointment, the editor window opens. Notice here, by default, Robert Resource is allocated to this appointment. Now, I am going to add one more resource, John, and click the Save button. You can see the scheduler here, multiple resource added to the same appointment. Alright, now let's have a quick recap about this session. We have seen how to add appointments of multiple resources to the Blazor scheduler, where you simply need to define the resource data source and map them with the required appointments. Now, grouping them visually on the scheduler is just one step ahead and also includes some additional options, which I'll cover in my next video. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link, which is shared in the description part below. You can also grab your chance of getting a free license key to use our complete Blazor products if you fit into our community guidelines. So check the link given in the description part to know if you are eligible for using our community license. Also, if you find this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thank you once again for watching this video.